Hi, I am Heather with One Shot Beyond Photography. I am located in Southern California, and today I am sharing with you my top three ways that you can get your video content to stand out online. And these are going to be really simple when you think about it. But number one, because I'm a photographer, I cannot scroll through Instagram and stop on a video that has poor lighting. So you want to find someplace in your home, in your office, outdoors, that has decent lighting. A quick tip on how to do that is just to use your hand. If you put your hand in front of you, you'll see right there that my hand has great lighting on it, which is gonna match where my face is. So I found the good light, and if I turn it, you may see shadows starting to form in other spots. Obviously, I can't turn it all the way around, but if I was this way, it'd be the worst lighting that I could get. And you can kind of watch your hand to see how that light hits it. And you want to pick a spot where it's well lit, there's not a lot of shadows in the creases of your hand, and that would be a good spot to do your video. Another tip for your lighting, you could always use a reflector, and I do have one right behind. I'm tapping on it so you can hear. This is just a three-fold poster board that is white from an office store for under $10. Sometimes you can find these at the 99-cent store. I'm literally sitting on my bed. I will try to take a behind the scenes shot so that you can see how this setup looks. But I'm sitting on my bed propped up against pillows because this was where the good light was. And then I have a reflector across from me and my phone is on a stand. It's just a, I would say it's a desk stand. So it doesn't go more than 2.5 feet tall. But that's my setting for that. So that is my first tip for you if you want your content to really stand out. My second tip is to always have notes on the ready. So what you're going to talk about, you have notes and you're going to look at those notes, try to memorize them as best as possible before you start. But if you get stuck and you don't know what to say, you can look at your notes and go, oh, that was going to be number three. So number three is going to be pick a quiet location. There's really nothing worse than going through the trouble of opening up a video on IG, going through the preview, and then actually opening that video up to hear the message that the person is saying and finding out there is background noise. There is a lawnmower going. There is several kids crying in the background or screaming or playing. I know I have neighbors in the back of me, so like today, they're out there playing on their playground, and so that's immediately in my backyard or right behind my backyard. So if I went and shot this outside today, you might be hearing those kids instead of what I'm telling you. And when someone takes the time to click into your video to actually hear your message, you want to make sure that they can hear you. So you want to find someplace in your home, in your office, outdoors, that has decent lighting. My notes are in front of me. Like I told you, you definitely want to have notes just in case you get stuck, especially if you're doing live videos that you're going to save and repurpose online. And then number three, again, you want the quietest location in your home that you can find, or at your office or outdoors. Try to pick that so that you don't have to re-record things. But if there is a loud noise, if you're outdoors and say a motorcycle goes by or something like this, definitely re-record that part and piece it together so that your content looks really sharp when you go online. Tips, hope you enjoyed them. If you did, please let me know. And if not, tell me what I can do to improve this video for you.